Hello, my MGTOW brothers. It's been so long since I've actually made a video. So this is my confession. I've been listening to videos on the MeToo movement by the women, by the feminists, and how they're coming out not only shaming men, but ruining careers and ruining lives and getting people fired in trading stocks and commodities and stuff like that. They said, you know, the market is over when they shoot the generals. You know, no means no started with the quote unquote low quality or beta males. Yes means yes started to actually go after the alpha males, the athletes and the frat boys and stuff like that. Now this yes means yes or the feminist movement is actually spreading out into the workforce. You're seeing they're shooting the generals. They're not going for the lieutenants or the generals. They're going for the corporate leaders. They're going for the movie moguls. They're going for the famous people and the celebrities. So you know that's going to filter down into to the everyday brother, to the everyday guy on the street. And I think men know this internally, intuitively, that they're next. If they can get the big guy, then what chance do I stand? And I was listening to Kerry Gakkari Jones talk about this. He does a video called Me Three. He was actually talking about this, how he thinks that this is an attempt to actually extort money out of men because the government atmosphere and policy is not conducive toward the gynocracy or funding the gynocracy anymore. So they're going to have to find alternative sources. So he believes this might be a way to shame men into funding or feeling sorry for women again. But I believe that, and I think he believes it too, that what's going to happen is the opposite. Instead of putting the fire out, the MGTOW fire out, actually going to put fuel on the MGTOW fire. In fact, it's going to probably grow exponentially because guys that were comfortable in their blue pill lives and felt comfortable around women, and even guys that were the masters of the universe or the alpha males that felt comfortable having sex with many women and actually on the other side caping for them, I think they're going to draw back and draw into their shell and on the workforce and even in public, you know, because it's actually getting bad to the point where you can't even breathe on a woman without her hollering sexual assault or sexual harassment. I think that more and more men will actually start withdrawing from wanting to even go to school with or going to college with women. Because now it's not one of those things where you're innocent until proven guilty. You're guilty and they don't even give you a chance to prove your innocence. Like they did with the first yes means yes in the Dear Colleague letter. They weren't even giving you a chance to be proven innocent. You were just guilty by association and guilty by accusation. And like I said, that's starting to spread out into the real world, into the public domain. And just like yes means yes, and the colleges actually started a huge MGTOW movement amongst the college-age students, which is why we got this big flood of young people. And I think for the working class blue pill guy, he's going to start looking up and Googling how to act with women in the workplace. And guess what he's going to come up with? He's going to come up with MGTOW. You kind of saw that in the Silicon Valley when I think one of the programmers actually typed in the company email about the gynocracy that was going on in Silicon Valley and how you had all these women that were actually invading male spaces and actually basically not getting jobs on their merit and stuff like that. And he got canned for it just for an email. And I think you had almost a revolt by the mostly male workers in Silicon Valley. I think was it at Google? It might have been at Google. And how they had to quell that. And I think that's going to be what's going to be like for a whole lot of jobs where men are just not going to take it anymore. You know, I think that these gynocratic policies that has been fueled by sexual attraction is going to get eliminated because most men, or I would say most men with something to lose, won't want to take that chance anymore. And already the feminists are complaining about it, that say, you just because we're coming after you and you're getting accused of sexual harassment or sexual assault, they don't, they're trying to say, well, don't stop mentoring women. Don't stop talking to women in private. And that's almost like a non-starter. So I think that a lot of guys that would never have even considered MGTOW are actually going to start leaning that way. And the ones that are already leaning that way are actually going to join. So the message will spread even faster because men have to put themselves at the maximum position of safety and advantage. And the only way you can do that is lessen your exposure to women, especially the exposure to this toxic femininity, this toxic feminism that's actually going around. I mean, it's getting to the point where it's almost literally not conducive or not safe to be around any woman alone. Because just on the mere accusation of sexual assault or rape or anything like that can get you locked up or get you in legal trouble that will take you years to extract yourself out of. And even the pickup artists or the alpha males know that you can bang 10 chicks, but and 9 of them will be cool. But what about that 10th? Or what about that woman that feels some kind of way 10 years later? Can that come back on you? There's going to be a lot to think about. There's going to be a lot of blue pill guys or formerly Captain Save-A-Hoes or simp guys that are going to have a change of heart. Because this Me Too movement is turning into a witch hunt. It's turning vicious. And I've seen more hashtag MGTOWs and more hashtag it more signs in the last month than I have in the last year. So while feminism thinks it's doing something to push ahead, they are. But it's like the Roman legions when they attacked Hannibal. They were so aggressive, they actually pushed in and they allow Hannibal to flank them. And I think that's what's going to happen to feminism. They're going to push so hard and so fast that they will get flanked. They will get outflanked by MGTOW, by MRA, by IDMOR. And when they looked up, they'll be surrounded. And then they'll be at an extreme disadvantage. Because the very people they need are the very people that they're hunting. And at the end of the day, they don't create their own businesses. They don't create their own industries. What they do is invade male spaces and they beg for money. And what happens when that dries up? All right, folks, that's all I got for now. Make this short and sweet. This is BGS out.